This is the chapter on master detail project. In our first lecture we have discussed the overview, and in our current lecture, in our second lecture, we will be creating the model classes required for our project. Create a new ASP.NET Core project. Use the empty template. And reach this solution explorer. The name of the project that we have given is Master Detail Project. We shall be using SQLite as our database. So let us add the packages for SQLite and also for Entity Framework Core. These are the two things that you should be doing for every project: the database support and the Entity Framework Core. So let us begin by adding these two NuGet packages. Come to the Tools menu at the top of your Visual Studio. Come to NuGet Package Manager and select the option Manage NuGet Packages for Solution. When you select this, a box will open. Select Browse. Type SQLite Entity Core for search. Possibly click here. This sort of a story will open for you. We are going to add Microsoft Entity Framework Core.SQLite. First select this one, and we will also be adding Microsoft.Entity Framework Core also. So we have selected this one. Click here. When you click here, the right side gets populated, and tick mark these and click on Install. Some boxes will open. Do OK and let the installation complete. Once the installation completes, come back and select this one and install Microsoft.Entity Framework Core. These two packages we will be starting. As we told, we will be adding first, and now we are adding this package. This we have already added. After the completion, verify that both the packages have got listed under dependencies. This is Entity Framework Core and this is SQLite. Now come to the Solution Explorer and add a folder called Models. We will be now adding model classes. So add a folder called Models and right click the Models folder to add a new item. Select class. Type a name for your model as teacher. Teacher will be our model class. So write type teacher here and then click add. After you click add, a teacher.cs file gets added under the models folder. Now let us examine what we write in this class, how we complete this class. This is the objective of the lecture 2. We will be completing this class today. That is the only objective for our today's lecture. Let us double click open and complete this. We will explain how to do this. Make sure that in case some errors occur while you complete at your own end, in case some errors occur, do come back to check these using statements. We have decided to create a table called TBL teacher. So our public class teacher, we have made an annotation table, TBL teacher. This will be the name of the table in the database. So TBL teacher. This TBL teacher is going to have two columns. One is email, the second as name. So we will need two properties. One property is public string email. The second property is public string name. Both are getSet. These properties we have added because our database table has to have two columns, email and name. Now let me explain these annotations. This annotation key is called primary key. This will make this email as the primary key in the database. This is the primary key and this key annotation. Then there is a required. Required will mean that any server-side validations or any validation errors that are occurring they will be shown because of this required annotation. So this field, this property will be marked as compulsory as required. When the user leaves it empty and submits the button, then this message will be shown, email is required. So this is how you can configure this message on the annotations. After this, you will see I have added one more annotation for display. This display has a value email ID of the teacher. Email ID of the teacher. This is a label that you will see on the razor page when we go to that step. This label will pick its value from this property. So most of the things are configurable through the code itself. Then data type is email address. This will set the type of this to email. This is the HTML5 input type. It will set its type to email. And similarly, there will be properties for the second name also. Name is required, max length. This will set the maximum length of this to 50, the HTML5 attribute, and also for server side validation. This will be picked from here. Required attribute, max length attribute. This display is again attached to this label. So this is what these attributes they mean. You are also seeing a third property that is added to the teacher's model. This property is a calculated property. What is a calculated property? This property, let me first show you. Public string teacher info returns name plus email. The value returned by this property is determined by two other properties, name and email of this teacher class. So this is a calculated property. We have written only the get, there is no set. Because we have written only get and no set, no database column will get generated. So this is only for our use when we use it on our forms or when we use it in or on our razor pages. Display name brief info. You can see when we will display this property, when we will display teacher info, we will use this teacher info for display purposes at some place in our razor page. And this teacher info, as you can see, carries the name of the teacher, a comma, followed by the email of the teacher. This display, this is a label of the HTML table. That label will be connected to the display name of this property. That also you will see when we do the coding on the razor page. So you will have to just take note of this calculated property. This is a property of convenience. There will be no database entry for this property. Next, you are also seeing a property for iCollection publication. Each teacher is one to many to the table of publication. With each teacher, we are attaching a collection of the publications. This teacher will be a foreign key into the table of publication. The list of all records in the TBL publication attached back to the teacher, they will be available from this collection, iCollection publication publications get set. This publication is the table that corresponds to this. This publication is the property that corresponds to this table. So in this teacher table, there are four properties. Email, name, these correspond to the columns of the table TBL teacher. This is a calculated property and this is the collection for your one-to-many relationship with the TBL publication. Next, let us come to the publication table. This is public class publication. This is the publication table. The name of the table in the database will be through table. And we want to index this ISBN as unique. So we can use the index attribute to ISBN column is unique is equal to true. This is also a way of setting the database table through the model attributes. This is identity property. This is the primary key. This is for the ISBN property required. Similarly, when we will make some data entry, this will make it a required property. Column. The column name in the database will be ISBN and order is 1. This means that it will be the first column. 0th column will be ID. So we can give orders to our columns. This is the way that we can do. Although this is not usually required, because why would we be interested in the column numbering there? But in any case, if you want, then this is available to you. The name of the teacher, and then we have a date of publish. The display will be published on whenever we want to display this property through a table or maybe through a data entry form. The label will pick, as I have already explained. Then this is interesting, display format 0DDMMYY. Like when I will be displaying this field for date of publish, then I want the format to be 3Jan2021DDMMYYY. This format, the format will be picked from this attribute. Then you are seeing one more thing. This is the column data type required, and my required, I have not set any error message, so it will be the default setting. Whatever it is, I have left it untouched, but I could have made it customized also, as I have done it above. Now this is a custom property for range validator. We would want that the date that the customer enters for date of publish, this date should be current date minus 20 years back. Current date is now the system date. This means we cannot hard code it. If we could hard code it, then we may have written like this error message, hard coded value. But if it is to be a calculated value, we will need a custom validator. So a custom property, myPubDateRange, we have added a custom class here. Public class myPubDateRange attribute. This is coming from the range attribute. The range attribute has the property. These are the properties. This is the minimum value and this is the maximum value. So when have a look at it, this is the constructor, and the base class is called with the type of date type, date time, that this is a date time type of range, and the, this is comma. This is the second property. If I clarify it, this is the maximum, this is the minimum, and this is the data type. So it should be clear. You can see it again. So this is add years minus 20. And like that, whenever this property is settled outside the limits, the error message would be custom. Date must be between 1. This will be today's date, or not today's date, rather 20 years back, picked from this property. This will be picked from this property. And after that, your TBL publication has a foreign key for teacher ID. This is that teacher ID, the foreign key. Corresponding to this teacher ID, there will be a property for the teacher class itself containing the complete information of the teacher. So that also has to be added. This will be added in pairs. This will be the actual object for the teacher, and this will be the field, the column in the database. So this is that teacher ID. See, ID, ISBN, PubName, PubDate, teacher ID. These properties we have added to the publication table. But one additional property has to be added for the backlink to the whole table of teacher. Just like we added this publications as a forward link to the collection of all publications. This table has a forward link to a collection of publications, and this has a backlink to a table of TBL teacher. This will be the actual key, and this will be the backlink to the table teachers. Foreign key teacher FK, this exact name must be linked here. This is important. So initially you may feel a bit of a difficulty in understanding this whole concept, but if you practice it a couple of times, then you will be very comfortable with this. Here I have completed this publication table. So my two tables are complete. The table for teachers I have completed here, and the table for publication has been completed here. Now let us also side by side complete the DB context also. We will call teacher context as coming from DB context. Public, this constructor is required. You must refer to my previous tutorials where I have explained this in detail. So this is the constructor, this should be there. A DB set for teachers, the teachers table, and a DB set for the publications table. For each table you need a DB set in your DB context, so these two properties are added. There will be a lot of behind the curtains, behind the scenes magic going on. We will not worry about that. That is being taken care of by the Microsoft dot entity core that we added at the start of this tutorial. The NuGet link that we added, this will be taken care of, that NuGet package that will carry on the whole story for you. So with this, my model creation is complete. And this you can practice or obtain the source code from me if you want. And this is what you should be doing. We'll meet in our next tutorial. Thank you.